Suppose we are trying to keep track of the colors in a bitmap, or elevation data on a map. While we could store this in an array, we think about the data two-dimensionally, like a matrix. Java allows us to write code that matches how we think about the data using multidimensional arrays. In Java, square brackets are used to indicate you are declaring an array variable. What precedes the brackets is the kind of thing stored in the array. Since that can be any type, we can also have it be an array. So, declaring double bracket 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 means that we have an array of arrays of doubles. As with normal arrays, we don't actually have an array until we call a constructor. Here, we are making an array with 3 rows and 7 columns. Although we can write this with a single constructor, what is actually happening is that we are first making an array of size 3, which will hold pointers to the rows, and then we are filling that array by calling a constructor to make an array of 7 doubles 3 times, once for each row. This slide shows a picture of what the allocation creates. Percentages is an array with 3 elements. Each of those elements refers to an array of 7 doubles. Java automatically initializes each of the doubles to 0. Since Java arrays begin at 0, the elements of percentages are numbered from 0 to 2, and each row referred to is indexed from 0 to 6. The method fillArray shows 2 nested for loops that fill a two-dimensional array of integers with random numbers from 0 to max minus 1. The outer loop counts from 0 to array.length minus 1. Length is the number of rows in this two-dimensional array. Inside that loop, we have another loop so that we can process every element of every row. The inner loop goes from 0 to array bracket I dot length, which is the length of the ith row. Although generally Java programmers create two-dimensional arrays where every row is the same length, the language does not require this. Adding this line of code at the beginning of the method would replace the first row with a row of length 27. Next, we'll show how to find the maximum value of a two-dimensional array that has at least one element. The code first sets max to be the first element, and then loops through the array. If it ever finds something larger than max, it replaces the value of max. Again, we use 2 nested loops to look at each item of a two-dimensional array. If we made a three-dimensional array, we'd use 3 nested loops, and so on. You can have as many dimensions as you want by simply adding more brackets. The size of the array does grow exponentially with the number of dimensions, so don't get too carried away. In review, Java allows you to create arrays of arrays, which corresponds to multidimensional arrays. When processing all of the elements of the array, you use 1 nested loop for each dimension of the array, and Java arrays are always indexed beginning at 0, going from 0 to length minus 1. You can download a sample program with the methods fillArray and findMax from java.martincarlyle.com.